Micah chapter 4, an interesting, great passage. But in the last days, it shall come to pass, surely come to pass, for sure it'll come to pass, that the mountain of the house of the Lord, the residence of the house of the Lord, shall be established in the top of the mountains. It shall be exalted above the hills, and people shall flow unto it. It's not happening today. It says people. It doesn't say Jewish. It says people. So that must be future. And many nations. So we've jumped over Jews to nations. Matthew 25. Many nations shall come and say, come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord. That's the last thing in the mind of nations today. If you go to the mountain that's being talked about right now, you'll find the Dome of the Rock of Allah and Muhammad. That's not God. Let us go to the mountain of the Lord and to the house of the God of Jacob. You know that's not happening today. If anything's going on over there in the Middle East right now, they deny Israel. They deny the God of Israel. They deny Abram, Isaac, Jacob, in the 12 tribes. And he, God, will teach us of his ways. Let's go back to Micah chapter 3. See what's going on. Verse 11. The heads therefore judge for reward, and the priests therefore teach for hire. The prophets, therefore, divine for money. Oh, they're charging. But when the Lord becomes to teach on this world and this nation as he's seated upon his throne, he's going to teach Israel, he's going to teach the nations, and he ain't going to charge you. Many nations shall come. He shall teach us of his way. Why are they coming to God to be taught? Now you stand in any public ministry today, any proper church on Sunday morning, and you see the multitudes don't come to hear the Lord being taught. They will go to hear what they want to hear. They will go to hear prosperity. They will go to hear that they can be healed. They will go to hear that everything's hunky-dory. But they won't listen to the God of Micah. He will teach us of his ways, and they will do them. We stand in the street corner and tell the people what God's ways are, and they don't do them. And we will walk in his path. What he teaches us, we will do. How's that? Obedience to God. And we're looking at the nation. How's that? For the law, the what? The law will be in the tribulation period, and the law will be in the millennium. And nations will be under the law. So you see, Satan's got it wrong for the church age. The law and works are yet to come. But they're not now. In the tribulation, you will have to have faith and the law to be saved. In the millennium, you have to have faith and the law to be saved. Shall go forth of Zion, where the Lord Jesus Christ will be. And the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. How's that? That's the Lord Jesus Christ. And he, God, shall judge. Many nations shall come. He'll teach them, and he'll judge. They're coming to be taught, they're coming to obedience, and they're coming to be judged. You will not have anybody walk up to Jesus Christ and say, "Judge not, lest ye be judged." Yeah. Not one of the apostles of the Lamb or the bride of the Lord Jesus Christ in the millennium on this land, "Judge not, lest ye be judged." They'll come to you seeking, "Hey, am I doing right? Am I bringing the right what?"
So in the millennium, they won't need law and faith. They just need the law. Well, Jesus will be there, so they don't need faith.
And they'll be, what Jesus says to do will be proper. Because you'll still have to sacrifice animals. You need to bring this animal. Okay, this is what you said I need to bring? Okay. And that's the thing with the judgment. Is this what the Lord wants me to bring, sir, angel, sir, saint? That's what the Lord wants you to bring. Okay, let's go. You know, in the time of the law, there had to be people walking up to the priest and say, "Is this what the law told me to bring? I want to make sure I bring what's proper." Because I'm not sure. I mean, have you ever read how hard that law was? And there wasn't just one animal for all sins. And then there was a hen of this and a wafer of that. It was just so much. They're going to be checking. Is this what Jesus Christ wants from me? And they're checking to be sure that they're doing right. You know, in glory, we'll never have to check our motives. Every thought, every idea, everything you do will always be right. Many people, and it says not all people. Why many people? He shall judge among many people. You read about Satan when he's loose? He gathers an army against Jesus Christ. There is a form of rebellion in the millennium that shows up when Satan's loose. They may bear with it, put up with it until Satan comes loose. And rebuke strong nations afar off. In the millennium, there's going to be rebuking. You're not doing right. And in Amos 8:11, the desire will be the word of the Lord that has been a famine of, that we read about. Amos says there's going to be a famine from the word, of hearing the word of God. Here, let's go get it. Let's go hear it. It's coming out of God's mouth. There'll be no question, "Oh, it spoke out of man. Man wrote it." No, there's the man. Behold, the man is speaking the word of the Lord. Who is the word? John 1:1. Let's go. Let's go hear it. Now, this is something really just radical. Because what we're going to read is scribed on the United Nuts wall. "They shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore." Peace. We're going to take our weapons, we're going to turn it into farm implements. We're going to turn it into transportation. We're going to do it without Jesus Christ. Notice how they did not quote the word, verse 2. Notice how they didn't quote, "We're going to go to Jesus." It's not Jesus, it's Jesus coming to us. We're bringing in the kingdom. Then Jesus Christ will come. "It's great man." No, it's not. You forgot verse 1 about the Lord and his tabernacle and his dwelling. You think if you just walk up to that building in New York, "Here it is. Here's the foundation that's going to lie all peace in the world." No. It's not even on a mountain. So you're wrong. You're wrong when you quote that verse when you're not on a mountain. You're not going to teach the nations. You're not going to bring them in the ways that's right. Oh, but you judge them. You got your own soldiers. "But they shall sit every man under his vine and under his fig tree." How's that? You got property? Micah 2:2. And they covet fields and take them by violence, and houses and take them away. You see how Micah is telling you what man does and what God will do? You notice how we are going back in passages that Micah's written. And what Micah told us that man in government is going to do. Jesus is going to say, is that your vine? Yes. Sit down. Enjoy the shade. Unlike Jonah. Enjoy the shade and enjoy the fruit of it. And none shall make them afraid. No fear is not now as a stupid bumper sticker. It's in the millennium, no fear. Again, Satan's got it wrong. Listen, when Satan does something, he does it out of time. Satan will take something that is godly and twist it to be evil. There's nothing wrong with love. But twist it the way Satan does, and there's everything wrong with it. Marriage, sexual matters. God has prescribed a way called the marriage bed. Satan has come up with a devise to destroy what God has done through adultery, fornication, and whoredom. For the mouth of the Lord of hosts have spoken it. Peace by God. A surety by God. No fear by God. Why? There are angels running around. There are the bride of Christ, the church age saints running around. There are the apostles of the Lamb running around. There are the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, the 12 tribes running around. There is Moses, Elijah, and all the prophets running around. Can't you just imagine the Word of God becoming alive by all those who lived it? They're talking to you about it. And then the one of the source of all that is all to be the Lord Jesus Christ there amongst all? For all people, will walk everyone in the name of his God. Uh-oh. And we will walk in the name of the Lord our God forever and ever. Religion is temporary. God is forever. I can quote that verse today. For all the people in Daytona Beach are going to walk in the name of their God. But for us, we're going to walk in the name of the Lord God forever and ever. Their gods will be destroyed. Their religion will be destroyed by the Lord Jesus Christ. You know what I get? I'll get peace. I'll hopefully get some kind of reign in the millennium. You know what they'll get? Hell. Judgment. Jesus Christ has already judged the nations at his coming. He's in the millennium. He is seated. The Jews, the nations, are coming to him for advice. They're coming to him for lessons. They're coming to him for the word. Those who rebelled are in hell. In that day, saith the Lord, I will assemble her the halted. That's the one that's lame. He's limping. And I will gather her that is driven out. Chapter 2, verse 9. The women of my people have ye cast out from the present houses. The Lord's going to gather you. Look at, look. This is what man does. This is what God does. Get your mind and your heart off man. For all have sinned and come short of glory of God. There is none righteous but the Lord Jesus Christ. Micah gives you God and he gives you man. I will gather her that is driven out. Notice how it doesn't say they. It doesn't say him. It matches chapter 2. And her that I have afflicted. God is afflicted because of sin. I will make her that halted a remnant. a group. And her that was cast afar off, a strong nation. One her. He took one man named Abraham, and look what he's got today. And the Lord shall reign over them in Mount Zion from henceforth, even forever. Isaiah 9, 6, 7, and 8. Luke 1, 32. Revelation 11, 15. And he shall reign forever and ever. I haven't heard that hymn in a long time. And thou, O tower of the flock. Now we're going to, do, Lord willing, do chapter 5, but look at verse 2 of chapter 5. But thou, Bethlehem Ephrathah. That's where the Lord Jesus Christ is born, the shepherd, John chapter 10. O tower of the flock, that's the Lord's throne. I got a note here. I don't know why I got this note. It says, McDowell, Peter, right there by Rachel's grave. I don't know why I got that there. A stronghold, the Lord. Lord is strong and mighty. Of the daughter of Zion, Jewish, unto thee shall it come, even the first dominion. The kingdom shall come to the daughter of Jerusalem, God's kingdom. There's been no kingdom like that kingdom, even before Genesis 1. There was no people like the Jewish people in glory. There were no people like people that believed on the Lord Jesus Christ through the gospel, as there will be in the millennium. There will be in the millennium, there will be God's people that believed on the Lord Jesus Christ and the gospel that saved them. There will be God's people, the nation of Israel, in obedience, loving him, doing what he finally told them to do. And then there will be nations there who are, you know, no one ever thought of the dead dogs, the ones that Jonah didn't like, the ones that Peter didn't like. And there they are coming to the Lord Jesus Christ. What a dominion. And there's no wars and there's no battles. All coming in unity to the Lord Jesus Christ. What a dominion. What a kingdom. Now, why dost thou cry out aloud? Is there no king in thee? Is thy counselor perished? Now watch the statement. For pangs have taken thee as a woman in travail. What is that always? That's pain and suffering. They're not living for God. They're in disobedience. That pangs as a woman travail. That is the judgment of God coming upon them. Babylonian captivity is coming. The Antichrist is coming for the Jew. Be in pain. That's God. Would you be trembling if you stood before God and be in pain? What ibuprofen, what medicine could you do when God says, be in pain? That's a bold, bold statement. And labored to bring forth, O daughter of Zion. There's that pain, the birth. That's what the pain is. They say the worst pain ever is for a woman to give birth. Well, as hard as that pain is, be in pain. O daughter of Zion, like a woman in travail. The Bible acknowledges the worst pain ever is for a woman to give birth. And he uses it as an example, as an illustration to his judgment upon those who do wrong. For now shalt thou go forth out of the city. You're going bye-bye. You're not coming in. You're going out by armies. And thou shalt dwell in the field. And thou shalt go even to Babylon. Now we know, talking to Judah, talking to Babylon, I mean talking to Jerusalem. There shalt thou be delivered. Not only Jeremiah warned them. There the Lord shall redeem thee from the hand of thine enemies. Ezra, Nehemiah, Daniel. Now also many nations are gathered against thee. Oh boy, there's the United Nations. They weren't in verse 3. They're in verse 11. Are gathered against thee. Who? O daughter Zion, verse 10. That say, let her, the daughter of Zion, be defiled. Let's mess with her. Let's abuse her. Let's defile her. And let her eyes look upon Zion. What do you mean look upon Zion? As they're going away. By, oh, there it goes. And they're being carried away, far away. Zion's becoming a distant and distant and distant picture. They're going away. But they, the many nations, know not the thoughts of the Lord. I will curse them that curse you. Those are God's people. Neither understand they his counsel. For he shall gather them as the sheaves unto the floor. And that winnowing floor, that threshing floor, pictures judgment in the Bible. That's where the grain is broken. And the chaff blows away in the wind. And the fruit fall to the ground. Arise and thresh, O daughter of Zion, the Jews. For I will make thy horn iron, symbol of power. I will make thy hoofs brass, the feet. And thou shalt beat in pieces many people, the many nations. And I will consecrate their gain unto the Lord, and their substance unto the Lord of the whole earth. Yeah, I'm going to take you out of that land, but you're going to get the final victory. God is not done with a Jew again. Never will be, and has not been. He'll spank their hiney. Then he'll put his arms around them and say, I love you. Now go get your enemies. And by the way, I'll give you a little help. I'll give you Messiah to take care of your enemies. They won't be back. You know, David fought the Philistines and fought the Philistines and fought the Philistines. And when Jesus Christ fights the enemies of Israel, they're gone. They're done. They're burning in the lake of fire, which burns forever. That's it. They're not ever going to come out of that.